All right, did I respond to Ray?
Yes, sir. Make a brief opening if that's
all right.
All right, at this time.
That's fine.
You've already heard Mr. Coleman's opening. I'll try not to repeat all that, and you've heard a lot of evidence already. I guess the simplest way to put this in perspective is in 2017, Dawson County had a new sheriff. He, as you heard, had been here a number of years earlier before that with the county, with the sheriff's office, in primarily in the jailer area, the detention center operation. He worked other places, but as a new overall man in charge of the sheriff's office for Dawson County, he found himself preparing a budget, which he presented to the Board of Commissioners around July 5th, I believe it was, of last year. The 2018 fiscal year budget process, of course, took place last year. It actually started earlier than July. There had been a couple of months earlier a commencement of the process by meeting between the Finance Department and the different departments, offices, including elected officials' offices, and outside agencies which the county funds and hold apart, such as Department of Health, that they don't directly control, but as part of their budget. Starting in early July, those same offices and departments were asked to come in to a series of public meetings. I wouldn't call them hearings. They were public meetings. They were advertised, and some members of the public actually showed up, media and otherwise, and those officers, including the sheriff, made presentations of their budget. He had already submitted a budget form package with the assistance of the Finance Department. On July 5th, he submitted the notebook, the three-ring binder that you have already seen in evidence, which is P12. That included the staffing survey from GSA that Mr. Hallsworth testified about. That would be the last tab within P12. And in that budget request, he made a request for a substantial increase in funds to cover the expansion in staffing that he would like to see to do the things he wanted, including, like I say, primarily staffing, but also including some capital purchases and other elements. The biggest portion of his budget request, as with the other county departments and offices, was related to a salary study that the county commission had done and went ahead last year and implemented beginning roughly April of 2017. And because those salary increases were an ongoing expense, that rolled over into 2018 and is incorporated into the figures there, both the requested figures by the sheriff and the figures as proposed by the chairman, and then the figures as ultimately approved by the commission. The process in getting to that proposal and ultimate approval was essentially the one that you may be familiar with, whereby counties are required to have a public hearing, not just a meeting, but a public hearing for comment that's advertised, and folks can come and say what they want to about the proposal. The proposal at that point being the one that had been made on August 10th by the chairman. The chairman had received the budget forms from all the departments and agencies and elected officials. He had the opportunity to hear, as did the rest of the commission, from all these folks in those earlier public meetings back in July. He had all that information worked with the finance department to develop a proposal, which is, as I believe Mr. Coleman said, under the Enabling Act of Dawson County, requires that the chairman, not a county manager or CFO, but the chairman, to develop the budget and make a proposal. As I say, he did that on August 10th. What followed were a series of public hearings, not simply the one public hearing that's required by statute, but three public hearings where the sheriff and his attorney were allowed to make further presentation and comments. And there was actually a fourth, which because of the inability of two commissioners, the chairman and another member of the board, to be present, they decided, they being the sheriff and his attorney, not to come and make another presentation to a partial board at that point. So there are actually four hearings that would have occurred over the course of August and early September. In the middle of September, after the hearings had essentially been done, there was a final hearing, a special call meeting. The minutes of that reflect that that's one of the three, at least, that the sheriff and his attorney were allowed to speak at, make whatever comments they wanted to. And that fourth one was more of a dialogue between the sheriff and his attorney and the board members. Questions were asked. The sheriff and his attorney responded to a number of things. And the meeting was essentially for purposes of review of issues and comments over the sheriff's budget requests and the justification that had been offered for increases. As with other departments, the sheriff had submitted those budget forms, and part of it was, to the extent increases were sought, justification should be offered for them, and those things were considered as well. So at that point, you had the chairman's proposal, you had a series of hearings. During that course of hearings, there had actually been an additional separate meeting, not a hearing, not a public meeting, but a meeting between two of the commissioners, Commissioner Nix and Commissioner Gaines, I believe, with the sheriff, to further discuss the current state of his request in light of the chairman's proposal. As a result of that meeting and following it, the two of them made a number of proposed changes in the form of a document that ultimately ended up being part of the final approved budget. It addressed a few other things, but significantly it added $260,000 to the capital budget for the CAD system you've heard discussed, $260,000 beyond what had been in the chairman's proposal. There was, I'm thinking something along the lines of $40,000 added in for the HVAC system and possibly some other smaller items. At long last, after all these meetings and hearings and submittal of documentation, and after consideration by the board, it came on for a vote in the third week of September, maybe the 21st of September. And the board voted a final approved fiscal year 2018 budget that will be in evidence. Actually, Mr. Holmes has already tendered. It's one of the petitioner's exhibits. That budget reflected allocations of monies to all the departments and agencies and officials that were revenue-based. the revenue that the county had available was projected. Of course, revenue for county includes general fund monies that come from a number of sources, licenses, other fees, permits, inspections, insurance, premium tax, and other sources of that nature. Significantly, the lost local option sales tax revenue goes into the general fund. And then there's separately a few other funds that are restricted to a greater or lesser extent, the major one being the SPLOST, which in this event is county's currently on SPLOST 6 revenue. And that sales tax revenue is, of course, limited in its allocations and uses to the purposes that were set forth in the resolution and intergovernmental agreement with the city of Dawsonville, and particularly in a ballot that was voted on by the citizens of Dawson County. That's been in place for 2 or 3 years now, and the projections that have been used in the budgeting process were given significant attention this past year, and they have tried to make the SPLOST and other projections of revenue sources realistic. Not simply aspirational, not what they hoped for, but what they felt that they could, in a conservative manner, expect to be receiving out of these different sources. What you will hear in the way of evidence in a little while is that the sales taxes have increased each year, which is what had been projected. And finally, it looks like in 2017, they either have matched or been close to what had been projected. So for 2018, it's hoped that the projections, as I say, are realistic. Realistic revenue-based allocation of funds is what was sought. That's what was incorporated into the final approved budget. As I say, the sheriff asked for a substantial increase in his budget for the reasons you've heard. The commission looked at it, looked at all these other budget requests in light of the available revenue, made the allocation, the appropriations of funds for expenditures, and gave a substantial increase to the sheriff's department over what had been previously appropriated. The sheriff's department, as you might expect, being part of public safety, has a good share of the total, the overall budget for all these agencies, for the whole county. The overall available revenue is projected to increase to some extent, although ad valorem taxes currently remain down, as you might have expected. They went down during the recession, and particularly due to a number of exemptions that have been put in place over the years. They remain down. The ad valorem tax revenue is still not what it was several years back. And you hear testimony about the difference there in terms of the impact it has on available revenue for distribution among these different departments and offices. The sheriff ended up with something on the order of 29% of all the funds available for these various functions of the different departments and offices. You'll see the information about that, the data, including those pie charts that we were just referring to in the exhibits. The pie charts and the information are presented, among other ways, in a historical fashion, so you can see how that changed over several years, how it has increased. The sheriff's relative share has remained roughly the same something in the neighborhood close to 29 or 30%. Between the sheriff's office and the fire EMS, EMA department, those two being the public safety sector altogether, roughly 47% of the entire county budget is devoted right for that area. The obvious reason being that commissioners regard that as a priority. The sheriff not only got the largest budget portion in that sense that I just mentioned, the sheriff got the largest increase in terms of all the general fund allocations for all these departments. He asked for the biggest amount, and he's pointed out that he got a huge cut in what he asked for as compared with the final approved budget. He did get a cut. He asked for more, he got more. He ended up with a cut between his request and what was approved. He did not, contrary to any inference or impression that may have been created, get less overall than the prior year. His budget from the prior year was not cut. I think that what you will see is that the Board of Commissioners considered the information, though it wasn't presented in the detail that you've heard over the last day or so. They considered the information that the sheriff offered. Not all points were covered by the sheriff and his folks in the presentations, but the things that were presented were listened to at length. He was given opportunities to speak at length, as was his attorney. At times, some of his staff spoke during presentations. So between budget forms, the notebook, additional written documentation and comments that were given, and all the lengthy comments that were made by the sheriff and others on his behalf, the board had before it considered a great deal of information. At that point of formulating that final budget, they took seriously their duty, as you will see in the evidence, to address these many needs. They had to do that in light of the available revenue. As always, that's the, you know, the place where the rubber meets the road for the folks in a governing authority that have to make these kind of decisions. The sheriff requests a budget, and that's what he did. The board sets the budget, and that's what they did. They've done their duty in taking those things into account. The evidence will show, I believe, that they acted reasonably, and the evidence will not show at the end of the day that they acted unreasonably, certainly not to the point of constituting an abuse of discretion. And all in all, they took their duty seriously, acted reasonably, as you'll see from the evidence, and came up with a balanced budget, as they're required to do by law, and one that they will explain took into account in a realistic way what they had available and divided it up in a reasonable way. And with that, I will stop my remarks and be ready to move in with the witness.
All right.